Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Eco. Something's a little bit different here, you might notice. I actually cannot find the old server I was on. I think it's gone. It's not there anymore, and so I have to restart. I don't want to make you guys watch all of the starting stuff again with commentary and all that stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and fast forward through the main portion of the setup, the basic setup for what we're doing. I like this area where I'm at. There's rocks located nearby. There's an ocean nearby. And there is food on either side, as well as wheat and stuff like that, and plenty of places to hunt. And there's somebody else living in fairly close proximity. So I'm going to go ahead and just do a fast forward mode. And we'll see you guys once everything is all set up and we can start doing some cool new stuff. All right. Bye-bye. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another Eco gameplay video. Today, we're going to be doing something a little bit new. We haven't had to do this yet, so I wanted you guys to be able to see it happening. We're going to be researching the research table. So, after a nice logout, we have a ton of points. And what do I need? I need basic crafting 2 in order to do the research table. So let's go ahead and let's get that now. Skill points, activate. Basic crafting might be in survival. Let's see, what is this? Basic crafting. Level 2. Boom, that was pretty cheap. Not a problem there. Let's go ahead and create this research table. It's going to take about 2 minutes. Other things we're interested in is the storage chest. However, I'm pretty sure I can get a free one if I go into Civics and just hit this for 1. I think that gives me it. Boom. There you go. I got myself a chest. So let's put that chest maybe over here in this corner, I think. That sounds pretty good to me. And I don't think there's anything particular that I need to put in here. I might put my seeds in here. Because the seeds are kind of useless. At this point, I'm pretty sure it's actually broken. Planting is broken. Or I should say, not just planting, but all farming is broken, I think, at the time. So if I just leave all my seeds together in one place, that might be worth it. I just right-click? Left-click it? No, I ate it. That's great. No, I don't want to eat it. I wanted to move it. There you go. Alright, so I'm definitely very much enjoying the fact that I'm living in a different, much closer to a constant supply of wood place, because I have been using wood out the yin-yang and continue to do so very regularly. On the fire right now we have some charred meat cooking and a whole bunch of wood stored up for that. I do take out my own stumps, by the way. Let's try to hunt this guy, because we... I don't think I'm gonna get that hit off. I should've just not wasted that other shot, but that's okay. Let's wait for him to stop moving. I think it's still a 2-shot kill for the elk right now. I don't see him. Shoot, my view distance could be a little bit further. I just don't want to sacrifice. Frame rate definitely drops with the view distance here. I mean, it's not optimized, you know, this game isn't optimized yet. It's not to the point where it's really quite set up for constant kind of stress to the machine. So my machine is quite powerful. I'm not getting enough of a view range to see where this elk went to. It'd be nice to see if maybe they could implement blood trails. Make it a little bit more accurate, a little bit more like actual hunting. Would be kind of neat, a burrito. Grab those as we're walking by, maybe. Alright, well, oh, that might be him. Let's try to get a flank shot. Got him. Oh, we missed. I think I hit a different elk right there. Come on. Where'd he go? Wow, this place is wicked cool. I'm a big fan of that. Just jump over that, I almost didn't see it. Had a quick intake of breath right there. I didn't see where that elk went though. But after pumping a couple shots at it, I kind of want to get him. I don't want to chase him into the mountains, though. I'm pretty sure they just teleport up the mountain, basically. They don't have to climb it like we do. Alright, I do not see the elk. Oh. That's definitely him. Oh! I cannot damage him on the other dude's property. I'm gonna keep shooting. Are you kidding me? Dude, I chased him onto your property. That's crazy. Does he know he can't be killed? Oh my gosh, that is so obnoxious. Huh. Alright, we're climbing down the tree. Get out of his property. Elk, get out of his property. I need you to move right now. I'm like putting my face in elk butt. Can you please, how far does his property go? I mean, I could look at the map, but that requires taking out the map. You're kidding me, man. You're kidding me. Well, that's not the most obnoxious thing in the world right there. I don't know what it is. We'll give him a minute. We'll see if he walks that way, I guess, on his own. On his own free will. Maybe I can check out this place. Can I get it? Come in? No? Alright. I wasn't going to take anything. I just want to look around. See what you got. Are you kidding me? Alright, well, he's not... Yeah, he's clearly not going to be coming back. He's not going to be helpful to me at all. We have 4 shots left, so we could take another guy down. I think I see a bunny up there. That elk. That elk just got away with murder. He doesn't even know it, man. He doesn't even know how close he was to dying by my arrow. I was like hunting him from on top, and I was like, I got this guy. He doesn't even see me. He probably did actually see me. He may have ran away if it wasn't the fact that he was on somebody else's property. I guess the AI knows they're safe, and so it doesn't make them run. I don't know. I don't know what the deal is, but that's kind of obnoxious. I mean, I get it. I get it. Maybe people use like breeding or something in this game. I don't know. I haven't seen it myself, but maybe that's a thing. And so perhaps that was why they kind of don't let you do that. But whatever the reason is, it's probably a good reason. Oh wait, let me pickaxe this. I'm not really sure what it is, and we'll pick it up. Might be coal. Coal's not a bad thing for me to have. Let's find our way back to the house. I think if I follow with the water on my right, I should make it there. There's a bunny. But I don't much trust my ability to shoot a bunny. Besides, on his property. On the other guy's property, I guess. Come on, get in there. Alright, well let's go ahead and pick up what we need, which is going to be this. And we'll eat one of these. Alright, protein and fat is coming up. Let's eat another one. Protein and fat more. Looks like eating another one would probably be fine. Protein and fat. Could use some more fat. Let's eat some just raw fat right there. And some more. And pretty close. Could use some carbs alone. What's high on carbs here? Everything I have is carbs and vitamin. I could get some wheat real quick. It's probably not a bad idea anyway, honestly, to have some. So why don't I do that? Actually, is there anything I can cook with what I have that'll give me carbs? High carbs. Charred beet? No, a lot of vitamins. Charred corn? That's a lot of carbs. carbs, fat, and vitamins. I mean, the vitamins isn't gonna help though. Now let's get just like raw carbs going, man. Let's get like raw carbs. So for that, oh wait, I actually need that back up. For that, I'll need to have in survival. Where's the farming one? I think it's this guy. Gives you a scythe. Yep. Oops. This is probably the only level of this that I'm gonna get at this point. I don't really know if I'll need anything more. I do gather a lot, and there's a lot of corn in a place that I'm gonna show you guys at some point. So maybe, you know, maybe there's value if I was to go there with it, but let's grab some wheat because I want to be making as many points per day as possible right now, especially before I log off, so that way when I come back on, I just have a ton of skill points and we can just start really building into this game. So I definitely want to get more intense things started and more developed things started to get you guys seeing some things that you guys may not have seen before. So that's good for now, I think. As I grab more on my way back, because I'm just obsessive compulsive. There's like a couple that's like in my way almost. It's like I can't walk by them. It's like ignore them. There you go. Alright, cool. So that was pretty productive there. Let's go ahead and eat. How much of this do I need? That was close. Another one. Carbs is now more. And if we could have some more fat. What's high in fat though? Is there anything I can cook that's gonna give it like a ton of fat? Carbs and vitamins. Carbs and fat. What's this? I don't have enough beans and stuff. That one's pretty good though. It's pretty good. Charred pitch is then for like stone working stuff. Alright, so it's getting dark, which is not ideal. Do I have any? I'll put some seeds down there. I think I want to keep all my food in the fire, though, in the private section, just so I'm set to go whenever I have power looking, that's fine. So let's put this in there, and let's put the charred meat in there as well, and all of that. So we only have a little bit of fat left. Ah! Let's pop it in. Let's pop it in. So that's as close as I'm going to get right now to balanced. And I'll have to keep increasing my stomach contents as I work. And that way I can get more and more available goodies for myself, more available points. So, all right, I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of exploring and walking around at this time. And you don't have to watch that, I don't think. So we'll catch up with you in just a little bit. All right, see you later. Alrighty now, welcome back. I just did a little bit of exploring. I went back to the place where I found a lot of my corn and stuff like that, and I picked up some more corn. A couple more huckleberries, and some beans, as well as some fireweed shoots. So, some more stuff that I can cook, some more different variations of cooking I can do to kind of keep me feeling pretty good for now. I want to improve on my cooking. I think that cooking is going to be incredibly important for this game. The more, the better your ratio and the more food you have, it seems like the better off you're going to be in terms of your skill points per day, and that is basically the measurement of how you are doing, is how many skill points per day you're able to rack in. So we have iron ore, put that with the rest of the iron ore. I got some gold ore, I don't know from where, although I think I found a whole bunch more gold ore, which is awesome. Definitely a fan of that. Let's put away the seed junk in here, though I really don't have much of a use for it. Which one is that? Beet, and this is beet. Put those with that one. To keep these as organized as possible. Corn seed. There you go. Huckleberry with huckleberry. I think these two just look the same. I don't think they're beet seed. Oh, they are the same. Well, there you go. All right. So that's about as solidated as like. Oh, I have a bean seed over here too. One single lonely bean seed. Well, that kind of doesn't make much sense to me because I thought beans were kind of seed-like in general. Alright, I'm going to put some windows in here, but I will put the research table down right there, I think is fine. Can't be placed there? Sure, you can. Okay, it was too wide. Alright, there you go. So what do you require? Alright, you're good. Research efficiency 1, though, in order to do some of these things. So, I'm gonna need a whole bunch of good stuff though. Baking skill book, advanced baking skill book, flatbread yeast, alloy smelting book, carpentry skill book, butchery skill book, hare carcass. I'll need hare carcass, wheat porridge. All right. So what I want to focus on, cooking is definitely up there. I'll need a lot of camas bulbs. I was told you can dig up the blue flowers with a shovel, and that did it for you. But I've tried that, and it didn't happen for me. So I'm not really sure what it is that they're looking for. Glassworking skill book sounds cool. Industry sounds pretty cool as well. Paper skill book. Lumber wood pulp. Laboratory needs a whole bunch of iron. Okay, alright, well, I think butchery is on my list. Agriculture is not going to be, because I think that's for farming, and I don't really think farming works right now, but baking will be. Stone and wheat, I'll definitely need some more stone for that. So, some stone and some hunting is what's going to have to be done. So, why don't we prepare some arrows. Let's do 8 sets of arrows. That's pretty decent. And we'll put... I guess I should put it in here. And let's do storage. And put that right there. Alright, good. So you're gonna need a lot of stone. And I also probably want to keep an eye on wood and just occasionally go back and get more wood. So it's never really a bad idea, I don't think. So... But for now, we'll just go ahead and we'll pick up the stone from over here. I am going to have to dig into... I may have to dig into the hill behind, like on that side of me. Or I might want to decide to go ahead and use... what am I trying to say here? I mean, because I have to find ways to get more readily available stone. It's pretty simple to sit here and just, you know... go back and forth like this, but I don't think it's terribly productive to do this. So I think a closer supply of stone wouldn't be a good idea, and I might want to do some digging and actually build it underneath me. That may be the most efficient way to do that. But let's go ahead and let's put the stone here, is fine for now. Let's take out, I have 32 arrows. That's pretty decent. Like, I'm pretty okay with that. And let's go to where the elk are. So I found a lot of elk last night when I was this way. I don't know if night versus day is really a difference in terms of the elk population, but in case it is, I'll go this way. I want to kill a couple elk for food. If I see bunnies, I'll have to try to kill them, although I have not had much luck with the bunny slaying, as in zero luck with the bunny slaying. Also, it might be a cool idea for me to get the arrow Fletcher stuff kind of going, so I can get different arrows and stuff. There may be arrows that are like significantly more efficient than others. Maybe some slow. I don't know. I have no idea what it looks like. By the way, this is the mine that has a little bit of gold in it at the bottom. So I think it's gold. So I'm very interested in exploring that one and pulling up the gold from there. Okay, here we have a couple options right here. You're kind of being wonky. I can't get to you from here. Oh, he's making a run for it now. He saw me. Or heard me, or whatever it is. I was hoping that maybe, you know, specking into hunting a little bit more would make me, like, quieter. Better at tracking prey. Oh, I can do this. We can do this hop right there. Let's keep our eyes peeled for elk of any variety on any size. I should say elk on any side of us. Let's go ahead and bump up the view distance back up again to 35 and just kind of see if maybe that helps. They should be running when they're that far away from me, but I mean, they may be like down here and I'm not seeing them. I don't see any elk over there. So this is the place that I was talking about that has a bunch of corn and a bunch of other goodies. There's a ton of good stuff here for you. And It does appear to me like the mountains have a lot of natural foods. The mountains and the forests have a lot of natural foods. So if you find your place yourself kind of struggling to make ends meet or to find the proper amount of caloric intake that's of the differentiating kind of categories you need to fill, try to see if you can't find yourself near a mountain. Or mountain stream is, I guess, what this is technically, because there's a stream right over to my left. And in the tundra, you also have fire shoot weeds. That's the firewood shoots that I put into the fire earlier. I didn't cook it, just put it into the storage there. Seriously? You saw me from there. Now I see a bunny way out there. And it saw me from here. Now there's a turkey. And I'm gonna go chase down the turkey. Oh, it must be these guys. Yeah, canvas bulbs. Sweet. So I was looking at the wrong flowers. I was looking at flowers that were significantly smaller in stature than this. So I need a ton of these. Or at least I should have a ton of them. Or a few of them. Or maybe a lot of them. In the meantime, alright, there's a ton here. So there's another turkey. There's turkeys over here too. Let's hunt some turkeys. Because they're easy, easy killing. They don't run very fast. They don't run very far. I feel like this server has, you know, animals running and moving further than other servers did. I think he probably went back up. I think he probably did. Oh, there he is. Don't you dare, dang it. Like, this is ridiculous. They shouldn't be able to just, like, hop all the way up the darn mountain. As easy as they're just walking. I probably chase him back down now. Where is this little turd? He's all the way over there. Let's see if there's anything we can do here. We'll be on this side of him, so if anything, he's gonna run towards down. Down, up. Down, up. Alright, here we go. Come on. Come on! Come on. What the heck? That's a hit. Come on. Alright, it countered it. Where you going? Where you going? Dang it! No! Don't you dare go up there! Like, I'm using way too many arrows for a turkey. It's gonna jump up again. That went right over its head. Not even close. Alright, I feel like I'm in a good position here. Are you kidding me? Okay, I got it. It was laggy a little bit. I used way too many arrows for that. Not at all worth it for the meat. Not at all worth it for the time that I spent chasing that guy. Let's pick up a few more of these bulbs. Well, it's nice to know that they're here. In case I ever need to grab some more. I think right now, I really need to focus a little bit more on hunting. So, it is this general direction in which I found the elk farm. Like, the elk herds. It was more than just like a couple elk. It was like herds of elk. As far as the eye could see. Here's another turkey. Should I give it a go? This place is a little bit more flat, I feel. Did that not hit it? You're kidding me. Come on. It's gonna jump up there, then fall down, then jump back up again, then fall back down. That's a hit. That's another hit. Good stuff. All right. That wasn't too bad. I think turkeys have a lot of tallow, which is good. A lot of that fatty stuff. I don't think I'm quite in the right area. I think the elk were this way a bit more. I remember following the stream for a little bit, and then I went, oh, huckleberries. Let's pick some more huckleberries, because huckleberries is one thing that I don't have a ton of right now. And they're also not located quite as close to my main source of property. They're not ripe enough to pick yet? Alright, that's fine. Let's see if these guys are. Let's cross the river. Oh, you can see like a whole bunch of goodies down there too. Alright, come on. There's a house here. Good area for a house, honestly. Ton of resources here. Almost every single resource you could possibly want. The only thing I'm not seeing any of right now is elk. I'll just load in. What is up with this thing? This is wonky. I think someone may have taken all the wood for this stuff. Because it's not like claimed. Yo! Come on. Oh, got it. Alright, we lucked out that it was buggy and wonky, but I'll take it. There's an elk right over there. Oh, way off. That was closer. Come on. There we go, that's a hit. We don't come too close at once. Yikes, a little low. Come on. Too high. There you go. Law progress, 1 elk killed, max 2 allowed. I've never seen that law before. So I don't know if I'm worried about it or not. Probably not really. Alright, so the sun is setting, but we have an elk carcass, we have a turkey carcass. If I could get one more hare carcass somehow, that would be an awesome, awesome day. So somebody clearly took all that they could from here. Oops, I didn't mean to actually shoot that one. I wanted to check to see. I can't get in there, probably. Not that I would take it, guys. A little bit higher. Dang it. I think I'm gonna run out of arrows before I can kill this guy. Got a hit on his butt. You really actually wouldn't shoot an elk from that angle. It wouldn't be fair to the animal because you're not gonna kill it. There you go, got him. Max 2 allowed. Alright, well I guess I will follow that law and I will refrain from killing any other elk. I'll just pick a couple berries. Here's all the elk I was talking about. They're all over this place. Awesome, very cool. So that was successful, guys. That was pretty successful. I think what I'm gonna do now is just kind of try to come up here. There you go. And I'll let all these guys go. If I can find some more canvas bulbs, though, I might grab those. And on my way back, I'll probably try to go ahead and grab. Was that a hare? Was that a bunny? He's towards the sun, which is gonna make it really hard to see him. I think so. Wow. There's one way out there. I think. Oh, this sun is ridiculous. I don't see him. This sun reflecting off the water is just brutal. I can't see. I can't see at all. I know I saw one there. I know that I saw one. But I'm not sure if I can get back to it. I want 20 of these. Because I think I saw that 20 of them were necessary for something. Come on. Get out. And then we put it back in. There you go. 21. Alright. So we have enough. In fact, let's grab a couple more. While we're here. I don't see them over by my place, so grab them. Wonderful. Can these guys be grabbed or anything? Nope. They're just normal things. Alright, so we'll go this way as the sun sets. In case we happen to run into those bunnies over here on a flat plain, I might have a chance of actually killing one, which would give me just enough things. Just enough bunnies and elk. Oh, there's a wolf there. Oh, he's running. I'll kill a wolf if I can. Not that I particularly want to, but I'm sure it's useful for something. I'm sure that... I don't think you get a pelt from it. You maybe have to get, like, pelts at a later time from it. What is that? Oh, it's a stump. Followed by a tree. I think the wolf is to our left, which doesn't help us really. Because although it's a flat area, the problem is that the sun just blocks any chance of seeing anything. We'll leave him alone. We'll scout this house. I wouldn't take something even if it wasn't protected. But I'm curious to see what other people are doing. How they're living. What they're finding. How far their progress is. He should really clean up after himself, whoever lives here. These are just, same place as, yeah, fiddle something or another. Okay. Is there any bunnies down there, maybe? If only we could be so lucky. This place is nice. This place is pretty cool. I'm trying to stay right now by the ocean, though, because the ocean is the only place I know to get home. It's the only way that I know to get home, really. Without using the map. And the map is just so obnoxious. It chunks your PC so hard that I will do anything I can to avoid using the map. Literally anything I can to avoid using it. So I think that this is the general correct direction. And if I just kind of keep the ocean to my left and kind of go towards that general direction, I think I will end up eventually where my house is. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, that was a pretty successful hunting trip, if I may say so myself. We'll catch up when we get back to our place and see what we have available to do for the night. So, see you guys in a couple. Peace out.